We continue with our tutorial on the processing of the beta-galactosidase images. We had already performed the micrograph processing. From these micrographs we had extracted some particles, we had rejected some of them that were strange, and at the end what we have is about 6,000 particles that were picked by a couple of algorithms, and the gallery, they look like standard particles, white particles on a black background. So the next point would be to try to analyze, to understand better what we have in these 6,000 images. So for doing that, we will do a 2D classification, and we will use this 2D classification as a pruning of particles, so trying to reject bad particles from this data set. So for doing that, the first step we will do is to reduce the size of the images. So we can do that with the pre-process crop resize particles. So we have reduced the size from 64 that has an associated sampling rate of 3.5 angstrom per pixel to a new size of 40 by times 40, and we have increased consequently the sampling rate. So at the end of this step what we would have is the same set of particles, but now they are smaller, as we can see here. So smaller means all algorithms will run faster, and also we have removed a little bit of noise, so the results tend to be better if we are looking for low resolution features. Okay, so the first classifier we will perform will be this Reliant2D. Reliant2D, we may look at the parameters. The main parameter is the number of classes and the set of images that you want to classify. And this Reliant has a GPU implementation or a CPU implementation. We have used a GPU implementation in this case, and this is relatively fast. So for instance, this has been performed in 25 minutes, and the results look like this. So this is a typical result of Reliant. So the images have been enlarged by 300%, so the real images look like this. So let's enlarge them again, and typical Reliant result is this one. So we have asked for 16 classes, but many of them are relatively empty. So for instance, this one only contains 16 images, while this one contains about 900 images. So good images tend to cluster or to go together into a few clusters, like in this case we have 18 here, and we may discuss whether or not these are two good clusters or not, but at least we see something with the shape of a particle. So a total of 10 classes represent the whole data set, and other images, not so good, they go to separated classes. So now at this point we would select these classes, the good ones. We would generate a new data set with the images that we think they are good. So these are about 6,000. There were 6,600 at the beginning, I think. So about 10% of the images have gone to these garbage classes. So this is a step here. So if we generate the particles, this is the step that represents that selection of particles. So these particles have been classified by Reliant as good, but we may reclassify them with a different algorithm. And for instance, CL2D is very good at identifying different classes. So we have asked for 16 classes, but normally we could ask for many more, like 32, 64, 100, whatever. So the classes are well separated into distinct clusters, and the problem with CL2D is that the bad images, normally they are also spread all over the cluster. So at the end, they are contaminating the each one of the classes a little bit. Not so much, because normally you have relatively few bad images with respect to the number of good images in each class, but you know you're spreading the garbage in the classes. So the good thing of Relion, that is, it separates garbage images into separate classes, but it mixes a lot with the good images, is compensated by CL2D, that is just the opposite. So CL2D spreads over very good class coverage, but the garbage images are distributed in these classes. So using one after the other is a good combination. So we have 16 classes, and these classes, you see here that CL2D is computing three different class kind of classes. So the classes themselves is the standard concept of class, so all 6,000 images are distributed in 16 classes. Then we have the core. The core is, if you consider one of the classes and the images assigned to it, we may analyze how similar these images are to the centroid. The centroid is normally one of these representatives, and the farther you are from the centroid, the more strange you are in that class. And there are thresholds that tells you these images are not trusted to belong to this class or not. So this is a garbage rejection looking only at one class. The stable core is also aiming at garbage rejection. So the CL2D is a hierarchical algorithm, so it starts calculating four classes, and then these four classes are split into 8, and then they split it into 16. So if two images are together when we have classified at 16 classes, we believe that these two images really belong to this class if they were together all over the history of the classification. So they were together when we had two classes, they were together when we had four classes, eight classes, 16 classes. So at the end they are together, along the history they have been together, so we believe that these two images belong to this cluster. If an image is jumping all over the clusters, that probably means that that image is garbage and the algorithm doesn't know where to put it. So we analyze the stable core, we take all images because we like all classes, generate the particles, and you see the images not belonging to the stable core are only 140. So it is something that it is a reasonable price to pay to be sure that the images participating in the analysis, they are good enough. So we had done that, and this is this protocol that we have here. So these are the almost 6,000 particles that we have as the stable core of CL2D. So we use Relion2D to get rid of bad particles. Then we classify the 10 classes of Relion into more detailed classes with CL2D, and with this stable core of CL2D, we were also able to reject particles, bad particles. Then remind that all this classification has been done with the images at the size of 40 times 40. So if we want to recover the original images, what we can do is a subset. So this subset is taking the full size particles that we extracted at the beginning, just before rejecting by set score and by Relion, CL2D, etc. And we compute the intersection of that big set, so this would be the full size particles, with a stable core of CL2D. So this protocol will find within this set, within the large set, the corresponding images to this subset that we have classified and we believe they are good. So once we have the classes, let's look at them again. So once we have these class representatives, these ones here, so we may try to construct an initial volume for 3D processing. So the initial volume is performed within this. We have a number of algorithms doing calculating initial volumes. The ones more used are these four. So either you take a PDB from a similar structure and you convert it to a density map, and then you filter it. Filtering is in here, so you can create a low-pass filter version of a related structure. But this normally is not very much recommended because you may bias the whole processing. So it is better if you construct your initial model from the data that you have collected. So for this purpose, you have these three algorithms, the one in Eman, RANSAC, and Reconstruct Significant from XMIP. So these algorithms are relatively simple in the sense that the input is just the set of classes that the representatives of those classes that you have calculated. And then if you know that your particle is symmetric, and in our case it is a D2 symmetric particle, then you also provide this symmetry. Then you would have an initial model of Eman, you also have RANSAC, but similar entry and significant. So the output of this, Eman is proposing 10 volumes. These 10 volumes, one of them, for instance, looks like this. There is an automatic masking performed by Eman. So this is one of the proposals. Normally they are sorted by correctness. So Eman thinks that this volume is much better than this one. We will see that this is really the case. So this was the first volume. What we are seeing here are the slices of that volume. We may compute the slices along Z, along Y, or along X. We can also see it in 3D. So what we are seeing here is the structure in Chimera, and this window here is taking the projection along this viewpoint from this structure. So we see that many of these projections really look like the classes that we have been calculating in the previous tutorial. So let's look at this one. This, according to Eman, is the worst structure. Really, this is not the structure we are looking at. But in some sense, it is compatible with the projections. So you see, some of these projections really look like the projections we had in our data set, but the whole structure is not correct. Some of its projections are good, but some others are not. Then we may close all this, inspect the analysis performed by RANSAC. In RANSAC, we see many structures that are not so good, and this is expected because the number of classes, RANSAC is designed for much larger number of classes. 16 is relatively small. So let's look at these structures here. This structure here shows a nice example of artifacts of incorrect initial volumes. So you see a pattern. The particle seems to extend from a slice 14 to a slice 28, 29, but still, well, when you are far away from the structure itself, still you see a pattern in the slices. So these are kind of stripes. If you look at a different slice direction, you see these stripes coming out from the volume. So this is normally an indication of an incorrect structure. If we look in 3D, it has some nice features, but they are not totally correct. So let's look at this. Some of the projections really look like the ones we have in the 2D analysis, but some other really are too different. Then we would have the result of significant. In this case, it is the one that we have chosen. And significance, you see, you don't see the stripes. There is no stripe coming out from this volume. It has the same nice features as the one in Eman, maybe a little bit more detailed in the inner part of the structure. And again, it looks like the Eman structure. So it really, this is a confirmation. If several independent methods give the same kind of object, probably that is a good object. So we can see that the projections really look like the 2D things. Actually, this is one of the ways to validate the correctness of this structure, of this initial volume. So we compute the reprojections of this volume that we have that Reconstruct Significant has suggested with, and we compare them to the classes that we have calculated. So here we have the left column are the classes that we have calculated in 2D. The right columns are the projections of the initial volume that look more similar to the left column. So we see that most of them are very well matched. This is the difference between the two. So this is the difference image between these two, and we shouldn't see any structure in it. We see a little bit of noise, maybe a little bit of a structure, but not so much. And they have been sorted by similarity. This is this coast. The coast is an error measure, so the smaller the better. And this is the worst image, matching image, so, and still it is relatively good. So we are more confident in our initial volume. And at this point, we would continue to the 3D classification, where we would reject some of the particles that we have collected based on the inability to construct a good volume from them. But this will be done in the next video.